Facts about overweight and obesity.
Key facts. Worldwide obesity has nearly tripled since 1975. In 2016, more than 1.9 billion adults, 18 years and older, were overweight. Of these, over 650 million were obese. 39% of adults aged 18 years and over were overweight in 2016, and 13% were obese. Most of the world's population live in countries where overweight and obesity kills more people than underweight. 38 million children under the age of 5 were overweight or obese in 2019. Over 340 million children in adolescents aged 5-19 were overweight or obese in 2016. Obesity is preventable.
What are obesity and overweight?
Overweight and obesity are defined as abnormal or excessive fat accumulation that may impair health. Body mass index, BMI, is a simple index of weight for height that is commonly used to classify overweight and obesity in adults. It is defined as a person's weight in kilograms divided by the square of his height in meters, kg/m2. For adults, WHO defines overweight and obesity as follows. Overweight is a BMI greater than or equal to 25, and obesity is a BMI greater than or equal to 30. BMI provides the most useful population level measure of overweight and obesity, as it is the same for both sexes and for all ages of adults. However, it should be considered a rough guide because it may not correspond to the same degree of fatness in different individuals.
Facts about overweight and obesity.
Some recent WHO global estimates follow. In 2016, more than 1.9 billion adults aged 18 years and older were overweight. Of these, over 650 million adults were obese. In 2016, 39% of adults aged 18 years and over, 39% of men and 40% of women, were overweight. Overall, about 13% of the world's adult population, 11% of men and 15% of women, were obese in 2016. The worldwide prevalence of obesity nearly tripled between 1975 and 2016. In 2019, an estimated 38.2 million children under the age of 5 years were overweight or obese. Once considered a high-income country problem, overweight and obesity are now on the rise in low- and middle-income countries, particularly in urban settings. In Africa, the number of overweight children under 5 has increased by nearly 24% since 2000. Almost half of the children under 5 who were overweight or obese in 2019 lived in Asia. Over 340 million children and adolescents aged 5-19 were overweight or obese in 2016. The prevalence of overweight and obesity among children and adolescents aged 5-19 has risen dramatically from just 4% in 1975 to just over 18% in 2016. The rise has occurred similarly among both boys and girls. In 2016, 18% of girls and 19% of boys were overweight. While just under 1% of children and adolescents aged 5-19 were obese in 1975, more 124 million children and adolescents, 6% of girls and 8% of boys, were obese in 2016. Overweight and obesity are linked to more deaths worldwide than underweight. Globally, there are more people who are obese than underweight. This occurs in every region except parts of sub-Saharan Africa and Asia.
What causes obesity and overweight?
The fundamental cause of obesity and overweight is an energy imbalance between calories consumed and calories expended. Globally, there has been an increased intake of energy-dense foods that are high in fat and sugars, and an increase in physical inactivity due to the increasingly sedentary nature of many forms of work, changing modes of transportation, and increasing urbanization. Changes in dietary and physical activity patterns are often the result of environmental and societal changes associated with development and lack of supportive policies in sectors such as health, agriculture, transport, urban planning, environment, food processing, distribution, marketing, and education.
What are common health consequences of overweight and obesity?
Raised BMI is a major risk factor for non-communicable diseases such as cardiovascular diseases, mainly heart disease and stroke, which were the leading cause of death in 2012. Diabetes. Musculoskeletal disorders, especially osteoarthritis, a highly disabling degenerative disease of the joints. Some cancers, including endometrial, breast, ovarian, prostate, liver, gallbladder, kidney, and colon. The risk for these non-communicable diseases increases with increases in BMI. Childhood obesity is associated with a higher chance of obesity, premature death, and disability in adulthood. But in addition to increased future risks, obese children experience breathing difficulties, increased risk of fractures, hypertension, early markers of cardiovascular disease, insulin resistance, and psychological effects.
Facing a double burden of malnutrition.
Many low and middle income countries are now facing a double burden of malnutrition. While these countries continue to deal with the problems of infectious diseases and undernutrition, they are also experiencing a rapid upsurge in non-communicable disease risk factors such as obesity and overweight, particularly in urban settings. It is not uncommon to find undernutrition and obesity coexisting within the same country, the same community, and the same household. Children in low and middle income countries are more vulnerable to inadequate prenatal, infant, and young child nutrition. At the same time, these children are exposed to high fat, high sugar, high salt, energy dense, and micronutrient poor foods, which tend to be lower in cost but also lower in nutrient quality. These dietary patterns, in conjunction with lower levels of physical activity, result in sharp increases in childhood obesity while undernutrition issues remain unsolved.
How can overweight and obesity be reduced?
Overweight and obesity, as well as their related non-communicable diseases, are largely preventable. Supportive environments and communities are fundamental in shaping people's choices. By making the choice of healthier foods and regular physical activity the easiest choice, the choice that is the most accessible, available, and affordable, and therefore preventing overweight and obesity. At the individual level, people can limit energy intake from total fats and sugars, increase consumption of fruit and vegetables, as well as legumes, whole grains and nuts, and engage in regular physical activity, 60 minutes a day for children and 150 minutes spread through the week for adults. Individual responsibility can only have its full effect where people have access to a healthy lifestyle. Therefore, at the societal level, it is important to support individuals in following the recommendations above, through sustained implementation of evidence-based and population-based policies that make regular physical activity and healthier dietary choices available, affordable, and easily accessible to everyone, particularly to the poorest individuals. An example of such a policy is a tax on sugar-sweetened beverages.
I hope you enjoyed this video. I will have more power to publish the next videos if you subscribe this channel and enable all notifications to make sure you never miss any videos in the future. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next videos.